赛后的参加放松，我用一个网球可以如何可以教他们如何放松他们自己的身体。
Now in this part, Mr. Zheng will do some demonstrations with the tennis, which you can try after the competition.
就说正常的拉伸我就不教了，一般都会。
I will not do the demonstration of general warm-up because maybe I think all of you know how to do it.
对，就是说，就是让他们背一个网球，就是如何放松他们几个筋膜链的一个点。
In this part, I will use tennis ball to relax my shoulder joint.
像一般打乒乓球，肩关节用的比较多，特别是前侧，就是在这个前侧的胳肢窝底下。
For table tennis players, you need to learn how to relax this part.
对，就是说你可以用你的这个网球或者是高尔夫球，去放松它。
You can use tennis or golf.
对，像。你如果一般人他训练的次数不多，这边是不会疼的。
If you don't practice very heavy, maybe you don't feel hurt in this part.
但是乒乓球运动员他们这边会很疼。
But I believe most of you will feel hurt after training.
OK, 你先试试，来吧，来，躺着。你是右手对吧？对，我这边还没用力呢，他就感觉到很疼。
I didn't even use any strength, and now she feels hurt.
这个点一般拉伸是拉伸不到的。
The normal stretch up cannot do any good to this part.
对，所以说你拉伸不到的点，你要用这种网球去放松。
So this point, you have to use tennis or golf to relax this point.
对。说还有一个点，你翻过来。对。
And another point.
对，翻个点是在这。
Which is beneath the shoulder.
酸吗？酸。
She can feel sore in this point.
对，还有个点，腰骨的底下的差不多五公分，这个点。
Here is the third point, which is just 10 centimeters beneath the waist.
对，像。这些点都是平常拉伸不到的。
This point, you can't relax it in a normal way.
对。
So you have to use tennis or golf to relax.
OK. 还有点，你翻过来。对。在这边腰关节的底下走一点。
The fourth point.
中公分。对，这边腰关节它这边有一个骨头，这么硬啊？你这个是手机吧？对吧？对，这啊。
Around your waist, you can feel a very big bone, and just 10 centimeters.
Bone, 就是这个 bone.
10 centimeters beneath that bone.
疼，疼吗？
You can see how pain.
对，说这种疼痛，长时间的积累下去，肌肉产生紧张完之后，就会产生伤病。
If you feel pain for a long time, like her, maybe one day you will get injured.
非常疼。
So you have to relax those points.
像我们这种一般啊，怎么掐都没事。
Because I don't practice, how much strength I use in this point, I will don't feel pain. But you are different.
当有疼痛感
，you practice a lot.
一定要用网球去放松，它这边所拉伸不到肌肉。
So you have to relax those points.
对，还有一个点。
And the fifth point.
小腿侧向移动，小腿的外侧，就是咱说的这边足三里，它会产生酸痛。
And In the outer part of the lower legs, 10 centimeters below your knees.
因为乒乓球它横向移动很多，在腿的外侧，跟屁股完之后，就是它这几个点都是很容易产生酸痛的。
Because, in table tennis, you will often use this part and this part.So both of these parts, you will feel hurt.
Okay, 看一下，他们有人要再来试一下吗？看检测一下。
Anyone else want to try to test?
Who want to test? You? Okay, okay. You, this hand play or this hand? This hand here.
You can see?
Pain. Pain or no?
Wait. Do you feel the pain? Yep. Pain? Okay. Here. Do you feel the pain? Yeah, pain.
No pain, no pain.
Yeah, pain.
就说大部分人这几个点都没放松好 ，OK。
So I think most of you didn't relax those points very well.
Do you have any question? No. 那我们现在就要讲就是速度训练。
Now we will talk about the speed training.
就是速度训练可能更要听的是这个教练员。
In this part, I think coaches should pay attention.
对，就是说速度训练啊，它总共它有包含有三个部分。
The speed trainings include three parts.
它一个是反应。
The first one is response.
还有一个是动作速度。
The second one is the speed of your gesture.
对，最后一个是这种移动速度。
The last one is the speed of your whole body.
对，像乒乓球打，他打乒乓球，他对于球的一个他来球的判断，这个就是一个反应速度。
When you play table tennis, you need to anticipate where the ball to go. So this is speed response.
像这种挥拍气球，你这种，它这个就是动作速度。
When you know where the ball to go, you wave your hand. So this part is the gesture speed.
对，像这种通过你的这种身体的移动，侧向移动，对，侧向移动，哈，侧向移动，哈，这种就是移动速度。
And the combination of every part of your body to move, this is the speed of a whole body.
对，但就是第二个就是影响这个速度的最主要的因素，大家要清楚。
Some key factors which affects the speed of these three categories, you should know.
一个是神经速度，一个是神经反应。
The first one is neural response.
对，像神经反应的话，像神经反应的训练，就可以举个例子，像 OK， 像神经反应，像球完之后就不动 ，OK， you can catch the ball， 像最开始的训练，对 ，catch the ball， you catch the ball， yeah， OK， 这种就属于神经反应。
This is neural response.
Yeah. Yeah. Good. 这种。这种通过锻炼，他只要练个三四次，他会越来越快。
After 30 times practice, will be sure be faster and faster.
对。Good. Okay. Good. 我们看。Good. Okay. 换一只手。
Change another hand.
Yeah. 换一只手完之后，他会有点慢。
When you change another hand, you will be slower normally.
对。他这种需要不断的练习。
You need to practice over and over again, and you will be faster.
Okay, you can try it. Okay. Good. 对，他比较慢，完之后。
She's slower than her.
My body, 就说你也可以说双球训练。
And you can also train with two balls.
Yep.
This one is harder.
说重是属于什么？神经反应训练，第二个是什么？身体的协调性。
The second one is the coordination of your body.
身体的协调性对于你速度提高是有很关键的这种
Body coordination is very important to improve your speed.
对，像身体协调性完之后，你可以通过一些绳梯。
You can use some rope ladders like this.
对，像通过一些绳梯的完之后的这种侧向移动啊。侧向移动。
You can do some sideways movement like this.
你或者说是做一些有节奏性闭环，这种就是你身体的协调性。
And you can do some movements with rhythm.
对，你或者说是做一些任何东西，说是有助于你发展身体协调性的东西，都是以后你的速度是会有提高的。
Do any exercise which is good to your to the body coordination. Those will all benefit your speed.
对，像很多时候他们喜欢用跳绳来发展。
China national team always use this to practice.
慢，对，快， 慢。
Slow, fast, slow, fast.
对对。
And you can change rhythm.
对，它可以有双脚，可以有单脚。
You can do it only one feet or two feet.
Okay.
It depends on you.
对，就说它可以开合跳，开合跳，开合跳，开合跳，开合跳。
Or open or close.
单独的，单独跳，对，很好跳，很好跳。
And forward and backward.
它可以有左右开合单脚。
Whatever you want.
双脚不同的组合。跳绳是一个很练身体协调性的一个关键。
Rope jumping is very good to your body coordination.
第三个，它就是说是什么？关于力量。
The last part is strength speed.
对，说这种力量完之后，你想要产生速度，你必须要有这种爆发力，就是说速度力量的这种提升。
If you want to improve your speed, you have to improve your explosive power first.
所以说，想要发展速度的话，就是这三个原则，一定要把握住：神经、协调性跟你的力量。
The neural response and body coordination and the last one power are very important to improve your speed.
对，像有。还有最重要一个是身体稳定性的练习。
And another very important point is the practice of the stability of your body.
因为什么？它肌肉它有什么？它有表层的发力肌肉，还有深层次的这种稳定性的肌肉。
Because you have two different muscles. One is very close to skin.
就是用于发力的肌肉。
Which is used to make strength.
深层次的是这种稳定性的肌肉。
And the other is which is deeper one. It's used to make your body more stable.
对，你身体越稳定，它的速度它就会越快。
More stable you are, more faster you are.
对，像我举个例子，很偏，像这种跳跃的话，跳跃每个人都会。
So you can do some jumpings like this. Everyone can do that.
Jump good. Okay.这个是每一个人都会。
Yeah, everyone can do that.
But 你用单脚去稳定它的话。Okay.
But that's different if you want to use just one feet to control your body.
Just down your body. Yep. You can do it one more. Okay. One more. Just down. Good. So, 这种就是一个。是稳定性的情况中，但你如果说是做侧向的呢
？If you do sideways, this is a hard one.
Good.
Oh, very good.
OK, 像像这种练习完之后，只说一个最基础的练习，它就像这种人，它可以有。它可以有双面，它
单脚，you can，
重就是说重稳定性的练习完之后，对速度它是有很大提高。
So you can do it step by step, from easier to harder.
单，对，是。对，说重它只是一个基础练习。
So this is just a basic training.
像重东西的话，它还有一个说侧向发力的一个稳定性，侧向发力。Jump here, okay. Jump here, okay. Jump here, okay. Jump here. Jump here. 对。Stop. OK。说这种稳定性先练好完之后，再去练一些速度，会有很大的效果。
You can do some speed training after you can control your body.
像这种现在所讲到的速度训练的话，最好的发展时间是7到13岁。
The best time for speed training is from 7 to 13.
第二个条件，速度训练你要跟你的专项相结合。
And the second one, you should do speed training according to your sport, table tennis.
三，速度训练的时候，你应该在所有的训练之前，说所有的体能训练之前， 说先是速度训练，再是力量训练，最后耐力训练。
So in the very beginning, you need to do the speed training first.
对，你不能说是先去做力量完之后，你或者说先去做耐力完之后，你再过来做速度训练，这个是没有效果的。
You can't do the power training or stamina training first. This is useless in the training.
对，而且速度训练你可以每天都要训练。
And you should do speed training every day.
对，像跟一些专项训练的话，我举一个例子。
This training is related to table tennis.
像这种速度训练，你要保证一定的量。
The speed training like this, you must practice enough time.
对，像这种任何的速度训练啊，就是你要给，你必须给他们计时。
You need to count time for the speed training.
说，你比如说有五趟。
有五趟。
对，像你手这个，他们想训练五趟，必须每一趟都要保持在一定的时间量里面。
For example, if you want to practice five times, so every time you have to do it within a time limit.
他这样才能提高。他比如说。
Only in this way you can improve yourself.
Okay. So, one, 像这种两趟的话，我给他计时。Ready?
Do this training two times.
就两趟 ，Go, go, 快。One.Okay. 他这属于比较慢，在十四秒。
He is quite slow, 14 seconds.
他可以说，他每趟他都要保持在十四秒、十三秒、十二秒，依次提高。
In the first practice, you do it with in 14 seconds. In the next time, you need to do it 13 seconds. And next time 12.And next time 11.
对，每一次的速度训练，你都要尽自己所最大的能力，才有效果。
In speed training, you have to try your best every time. And it will have some effects.
像这种是一种，中国队他们很喜欢抛球训练。
China national team also use some trainings like throw the balls.
抛这个训练，他们可以从最开始的，就是很慢的。就一下子，慢接掉。
From the beginning, you can do it slowly, but quicker and quicker.
对，像这种就是这种是初级。
This is the beginning level.
Okay. 就是用乒乓球技法。对啊，看这样。Push, one, good, good, good. 对，像这种是。比较慢的，就是只有一下的。还有一种训练是比较快的。快。对。
Yeah, this is the faster one.
快。对。还可以用双球记忆去训练，就是更加难度的训练。
And you can also use two balls at the same time.
球抛远。抛远。
Very good.
像，就是你速度训练，你必须要慢慢的去提高它这个等级。
You need to speed up, one by one.
Okay. You come here. Okay. You can do 做一些小碎步 ，do some small step.
Quick steps.
You can do as well. One my finger. Here. Okay. Over here. Yeah. You can do. Yeah. Back.这个是我的正手，这个是我的反手，这个是我的侧身，这个是我的上部，用直拍手。
Which hand you carry the racket?
Forehand, backhand, back heel, hip up. Understand? Okay. 对。Good. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yep, yep, yep. Rotate your body.Yep, okay, here, here. 像这种训练就是跟专项相结合的训练。Thank you.
So this kind of training is related to table tennis.
You understand? 还有一个是 你比如说在举个例子啊，
For example，
像台上摆固定的点
，You can put some certain targets on the table.
One, two, three, four. Three, four, five, six. 刚开始的时候，他们可以用他们可以自由跑。第二，动，有弄会。Slowly.
Yeah,
okay. Middle speed. Yeah, okay. Ready? One. Yeah, touch and back. Two. Yeah, touch and back. Four. Okay, touch. Six. Yeah. Six. Good. One. Yeah.
Just listen to the orders Mr. Zheng gave. Number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, number six.
对，像还有一种说是给他。
And we can make it harder to use this band.
You can touch. Yeah, okay. Okay. Three. Okay, go. One, good. Okay, two. One, good. Four, six, good. 像这种围绕球台的这种不停跑动的训练。
If you don't use any tools, it's just the beginning level. Then you use some tools like band. This is intermediate training.
还有一种训练就是你运用弹力带去进行你的一些专项的侧滑步，像绑在身上完之后。
这就相当于最高级。
对，你可以进行一些侧滑步训练。
And the last level, advanced level, you can use these bands to do some slide steps in table tennis.
像这种。还有一个是练这种灵敏性的，灵敏性的，他们可以用绳梯。
And you can use the rope, a rope ladder like this, to do some agility training.
对，他们可以做一些纵向练习。
This is also the advanced level.
对，他们也可以做一些侧向练习，侧向练习 quick. 这种是属于侧向练习。
You can do it just straight forward.Or in a parallel line.
对，你或者说你可以做一些更加高级的。
Or you can do both at the same time.
对，或者他们也可以通过这一个绳梯来，他们来做一些上肢的训练。
And you can use rope ladder to do some training for your upper limb.
对，上肢。这个是很好用的。
So the rope ladder is a very good tool in speed training.
对，像这种它还可以练一些节奏性的训练。
And you can also do some rhythm training with this rope ladder.
对，像到了后面，你可以用这个绳梯结合球的训练。绳梯跟球的结合。
In this part, you can use the ball with the rope ladders.
Yep. Okay. Like.
This is the higher level. You need to pay highly attention to this training.
速度训练完之后就是。总归来说啊，就是先是以身体的重量，去训练灵敏性。
For speed training, in the beginning level, you need to learn how to control your body.
对，第二个，它可以借助外在的东西。
And in second level, you can use some tools to improve your agility.
对，第三个就是跟你的专项相结合。
And in the highest level, you can do some training which is related to table tennis.
对，像跟专项相结合的话，就是乒乓球，它就是左右的移动跟前后的移动。
So the training related to the table tennis is the movement, forward, backward, and leftward, rightward.
对，说，最主要就是这几种训练。
就是专项训还是速度训？
对。就是这样子。
So that's all for the speed training.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.